So this is going to be a quick video about Musescore MIDI export problems. So one problem with Musescore is it doesn't export notebends very well. Like, notebends have so many limitations, it's so fucking annoying because you can only bend up and you can't bend down. To bend down, you have to bend up first and then you can bend down. And these portamentos, and that's not portamento, this is a portamento, so it's a slide. You'll play the last note you end on, and it's like it makes an annoying sound. But anyway, that aside, the actual export to MIDI sounds nothing like the original. So here's the original from the extended event. Actually, let me turn off my mic first. Now I'll show you the MIDI version. So the first playback was a bit glitchy because the MIDI playback on Windows isn't perfect. But anyway, you saw how flat that was. The note didn't actually bend down that much. And I'll try showing some other tracks. Okay, what's that? Goodbye to the Underground is a good one. So good night, Porter. This is what it sounds like. I'm aiming for like a very particular sound effect that you get from Undertale with the vibratos. As you can see, it kind of sounds like honky tonk. Let me load up the. Was it? Goodbye to the Underground. As you can see, the line barely wobbles. I'll show you another section where it's really obvious and ruins the piece completely. As you can tell, that doesn't sound very right, did it? I'll show you the actual Musescore version. As you can see, there's a lot of note bend problems. Some note bends will work, some note bends won't, but majority of them do not work. And well, they do work, but like they don't like they're not full capacity, like, compared to what you hear in Musescore. Like, I think the largest range is something like 10 whole tones worth. It's like an octave and a bit extra, actually. I just create Musescore. Let's play violin. And I'll add gliss. So that's what it sounds like by default, but you can set the note slide mode, which is portamento. You can fade in all sort of fancy stuff. Anyway, I'll do that. You can see it kind of like farts before the end. let me add a tempo marking. Make it a bit slower. So you can hear the farts a bit better in high resolution. As you can see, it doesn't like there's a range limit. The other limitation with the editor is you can only bend like in one direction. I mean, like, if you want to bend down from, let's say, from F, let's say you want to bend down F to, I don't know, well, let's say from G, just make things simple. I'll make it to G to F. Hang on, that's a bit too slow. Sounds okay. See how it works with faster notes there. And see what happens. Hang on. Let's make it like that. So you can hear it's like it's starting a note bend after it like plays a note. You can, I'll pray this way, I'll make it like this. You can hear it, and the shorter the period, you can make it, edit, paste, half duration. You can hear it's like, it sounds a lot different, eh? And, try again. And you can see it's kind of like fucked up completely. It doesn't even sound in tune anymore. This is one of the problems. And like, let's make this a bit faster. Let's make it 400. It doesn't even sound in tune. A bit more reasonable number. A lot of note bend problems with Musescore. If I would do the so one of the things I wanted to do in Hopeless Romantic is do expanding vibrato, which you can hear here. It sounds like this. Anyway, so that's kind of what I did, but if I were to like hang on. Try a note slide between the two notes. Let's see. Oh, I can't copy it? Wow. Portamento. Portamento. There we go. Sounds alright though, that's strange. Well, you. Hang on. Okay, yeah, you can see what's like. It doesn't really work too well. What did I do here? So the way I did this thing is, I'm using a sine wave sound font because it's the least affected, but it's still not perfect. It's not like pure sine. It's a bit weird. It's kind of like a, it still has like two harmonics in it. It's not, anyway. So yeah, I first did a narrow saw band and then vibrato and expanding vibrato. You can't modify these by any way. It just says placement and just, that's it. It really sucks. And then I did that here with a very slight detuning. Yeah, detuning and expands. And then I just went like, you know, fuck it, I'm just gonna go, what you call it, tremolo, which is like between the two notes. Like even if I added a glissando to here, it's not gonna do jack shit. Like you can hear it. It doesn't actually change anything here. So. Yeah. But yeah, it does not the effects don't stack in Musescore, unfortunately. It's not a tracker, it's not a music tracker, so you can't like do expand stuff. They said, well, Musescore is not a digital audio workstation, but we're working on it. There's Musescore 4. Musescore 4 is fucking horribly broken. It's like literally unusable for me. Like you even try the browser menu to get the thing crashes. Yes, I know. Thanks. Thank you, Mega. Mega likes to delete my files permanently for some reason whenever I try to save, so I have to like double save it. Yeah, this is one of the new tracks I'm working on. It's actually quite a nice track, if you ask me. It's hopefully romantic. I like to try to replicate original as much as possible and transcribe. So this is the original sounds. FOD. Here it is, uncompressed. It sounds like this. As you can see, there's an expanding vibrato right here that I'm trying to replicate. It's not really a vibrato because this, so what's going on in this thing, it's running at 244 hertz originally, and then the export is like, I'm going to trim it because this standard Nintendo is can only play 60 hertz, so it just kind of like just cuts it up and butchers it, and so it looks like a mess here, but that's kind of intended weird effects from the original artist. So yeah. So yeah, I'm not actually too upset about the fact I can't do the exact thing here, but I want to like fade into it better, but there is no good way to do it, and it just kind of just cuts into it, like, you know. Can't have everything with a free software, can you?